Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Listen up. I'm Drill Sergeant Calero, and over the next 9 weeks, it's my job to turn you from civilians into soldiers, the most elite fighting force on the planet. You do what I say when I say it. Oh, now get off my bus. Platoon, listen up. Fall into a horseshoe formation around me. What you see in front of you is the fit to win obstacle course. Before you can learn how to fight like a soldier, you have to learn how to move like a soldier. Once the exercise is started, complete each obstacle as quickly as possible. I want 110%. Okay, let's begin the exercise. We'll start with the soldier in the middle, who's been so quiet. Yeah, that's right. I'm talking to you, hero. You're using the white lane on this course, so make sure you stay in your lane. All right, hero, get in position. Fall into the starting position. We're burning daylight, soldier. Move out. Bulldogs, listen up. Welcome to the Bastogne Range. This multi-purpose range serves various weapons platforms. Behind me is the 300-meter rifle range. Through those doors over there is the explosive range, and over there is the projectile munitions range. Since you're here to qualify with your M16A4 rifle, you should only be at this range. No wandering around. Remember to always stay behind the firing lines. Keep your weapon pointed up and down range. Take all your commands from the towers. This will be a live fire exercise, so safety is paramount. I don't want to write your mamas and lie about how smart you were. Now look at lane number 4. This private is demonstrating the proper position in the firing box. He will fire at the targets in his lane and his lane only. When he's finished, he'll place his weapon on safe and come back across the firing line. Too easy. You're on lane 3. Go to the supply station and get your ammo from the supply specialist. Double time. Range walk, soldier.
Pick up your weapon and magazines off the table, soldier. How you doing, recruit? I'm Sergeant Osuna, a 92 Yankee.
You look confused.
It takes a while to learn the MOSs. I'm a unit supply specialist. If there is something you need at the range, you just let me know, and I'll have it for you.
assume a good firing position. Lock and load one magazine of 20 rounds. Ready on the right. Ready on the left. The firing line is ready. Fires, place your selector lever on semi-automatic. Fires, commence fire when your targets appear. Lock and load one magazine of 20 rounds. Fires, assume the prone position. The firing line is ready. Fires, place your selector lever on semi-automatic. Fires, commence fire when your targets appear. Ceasefire. Lock and load one magazine of 20 rounds. Fires, assume the kneeling position. The firing line is ready. Fires, place your selector lever on semi-automatic. Fires, commence fire when your targets appear. Thank you. fire, cease fire, cease fire.
Hey, don't call this the gunfighter phase for nothing, soldier. This time around, you're gonna go to each station for familiarization and qualification on the M320 grenade launcher, the M249 squad automatic weapon, and through that bunker door over there, you're gonna learn how to throw hand grenades. Report to the drill sergeants at the stations to practice with a weapon. When you're done, return the weapon to the drill sergeant before you leave the station. Once you complete your qualification for all three stations, come back to me, and we'll review your performance.
Welcome to the M320 training range, soldier. Pick up an M320 and some training rounds from the table. Practice finding the targets, and when you're ready, speak to me at 4 o'clock. So you think you're ready to qualify with the M320. Your qualification begins in 10 seconds.
Shooter ready. Stand by.
So you think you're ready to qualify with the M320. Your qualification begins in 10 seconds.
Shooter ready. Stand by.
Welcome to the automatic rifle station. The M249 air-cooled, gas-operated, fully automatic firearm is used for squad support. Practice with the weapon and speak to me when you are ready to qualify.
Enemy spotted. Enemy spotted.
So you're ready to qualify? Let's see if you're an effective automatic rifleman. Your qualification begins in 10 seconds.
Shooter ready. Stand by.
Outstanding, soldier! Huh!
Welcome to the grenade range, soldier. Here you will learn proper use of the M67 fragmentation, M84 flashbang, and the M83 smoke grenades. You will find grenades in the boxes here at this station. Take some time to practice. When you are ready, speak to me to qualify.
Out. Frag out. frag out! Frag out! Frag out!
You will need to place an M67 near the targets that present themselves. All right, soldier, let's see how you do.
Stand by.
Frag out! Frag out! Frag out! Frag out! Frag out! Frag out!
Outstanding!
All right, Privates. I know most of you are tired from training, but stay alert, because what we learn here could save your buddy's life. We're now going to cover combat life-saving, or CLS. This class is a combination of lecture and hands-on exercises to ensure that you know how to treat casualties in the field. Many of the techniques we'll cover here are based on basic first aid principles that you may already be familiar with, but the intent of this class is to cover specific CLS treatments that will enable you to revive and stabilize your fellow soldier out on the battlefield. Now, before we get started, we're going to watch a short introductory video.
As a soldier in the United States Army, you are the first link in a chain of trained professionals delivering escalating levels of treatment. As the first responder, your initial care is crucial to successful treatment. It is your duty to be proficient in your combat life-saving skills. If your buddy lies injured on the battlefield, quite possibly, the only thing that is going to save him is you and your ability to use the skills you learn here. Every U.S. Army soldier is issued in BIFAC. This kit is far more advanced than the typical first aid kit you may be familiar with in the civilian world. Your IFAC includes equipment to treat the most common life-threatening battlefield injuries you will see in combat. This equipment requires more advanced medical training than basic first aid. For instance, this is a nasopharyngeal airway, or NPA. It is usually used with conscious patients who are unable to maintain an open airway. Some people call it a nasal trumpet because of its shape, and also because you insert the NPA into the nostril of a casualty in order to establish a patent airway. Not all breathing problems involve a closed airway. Penetrating thoracic injury may present as a sucking chest wound, causing air to enter the pleural space. This creates internal pressure that can prevent the patient from breathing properly, a condition called open pneumothorax. To minimize this pressure, you apply the Ascherman chest seal over the sucking wound. The seal allows air out, but not in, stopping the pressure buildup. Some of the equipment in your IFAC simply improves on standard treatment that you may be familiar with from basic first aid. The Combat Application Tourniquet, or CAT, is a small and lightweight one-handed tourniquet that completely occludes arterial blood flow in an extremity. This tourniquet is not only faster to apply than traditional equipment, but can be applied to oneself with one hand. This all may sound intimidating or even gross to some of you, but we train you to overcome those fears in order to save lives. By practicing the treatments you're about to learn and mastering the contents of your IFAC, you'll be an effective lifesaver on the battlefield.
On each of your tables is a state-of-the-art simulation mannequin called a Sim Man, but I like to call him Simon. He's your buddy. Simon can breathe like a person, react like a person, and even bleed like a person. You have the ability to help Simon if you know what to do. Now that you've been introduced to some of the tools, let's get into how and when to use them. Gunshot wounds will obviously be a very common injury that you'll encounter on the battlefield. We'll cover the most common wounds and how to handle them. With a basic gunshot wound, it's possible for the bullet to pass right through the body, completely missing bone and major organs. When this happens, the primary treatment is to apply a field dressing. This will prevent further blood loss and stabilize the soldier. Now let's practice. I've given your Sim Man a gunshot wound. Use a field dressing to stop the bleeding. You have properly applied a field dressing. Good job. Let's move on. If the wound is to an extremity, it may have damaged an artery. This is a critical injury because blood loss will quickly kill the victim unless you apply a tourniquet to stop the bleeding. Place the tourniquet above the wound and then tighten it until the bleeding slows. After applying the tourniquet, make sure to mark the victim's forehead with a letter T. This will notify medical personnel that a tourniquet has been applied. It looks like Simon's having a bad day. Go ahead and treat his injuries. It looks like everyone figured this one out. Excellent work. Good job, everyone. Let's move on to the next section. As you learned in first aid, establishing a clear airway is a key to a wounded soldier's survival. Breathing brings air into the lungs and allows oxygen to enter the bloodstream. If a person is not able to breathe, then they will quickly lose consciousness, and without proper treatment, they will die. When a soldier is unable to breathe, it is essential that you restore the airflow to his lungs. When a soldier has suffered an obstructed airway, use a nasopharyngeal airway, or NPA. This type of airway adjunct will restore proper breathing and prevent asphyxiation. Take a look at Simon. He's unconscious and not breathing. You need to quickly apply the proper treatment for all his wounds. I'll monitor your treatment from my workstation. Good job, everyone. You've successfully treated the severely injured soldier. An open pneumothorax, commonly known as a sucking chest wound, is a severe wound that allows air into the cavity between the chest wall and the lung, but it doesn't allow air to escape. As the pressure inside the torso builds up, it prevents the lung from fully inflating. The proper treatment of an open pneumothorax is an Ascherman chest seal, a one-way valve that's designed to let air and blood escape from the wound while preventing the re-entry of either. All right, let's move to the next practice situation. Looks like poor Simon can't seem to catch a break. He's really shot up this time. Treat all of his injuries. Very impressive. I had a feeling about this class. When a soldier falls unconscious, it can be from a number of reasons, ranging anywhere from blood loss to asphyxiation. Reviving a downed soldier allows you to get him to a safe location so you can treat his wounds more effectively without fear of becoming a casualty yourself. First, we'll start with blood loss. Severe blood loss will cause the heart rate to slow. In order to revive a soldier who's suffering from blood loss, use the saline IV from your IFAC. Now I'm going to incapacitate Simon from blood loss. You'll need to revive him and then treat his injuries. Excellent work, everyone. Now move on to the injuries. Good job, everybody. You've successfully treated his injuries. All right, let's move on. A soldier who has collapsed from asphyxiation due to an airway compromise needs immediate restoration of the airway. When this is the case, the item to use is another airway adjunct called OPA, or oropharyngeal airway. I've given Simon an airway compromise. Now treat him properly. Looks like everybody knows how to use an OPA properly. Now let's move on to treating his injuries. Excellent. It looks like everybody's treated their Sim Man's injuries. Injuries from falls and impacts can severely hinder a soldier. The pain from some of these injuries can incapacitate a soldier, making it impossible for him to move. When a soldier is suffering from an injured limb, a splint can be applied to increase mobility and allow the soldier to function. Now let's practice applying a splint. Great job, everyone. Your patient is now able to move properly. Now that he's mobile, treat the rest of his injuries. All right, stick with me, people. We're almost done here. Blunt trauma and pain can overwhelm a person and render them unconscious due to shock. A common symptom of this condition is pale skin. Smelling salts are a chemical compound made from ammonium carbonate, which can restore consciousness to an incapacitated soldier if inhaled. I think you know the drill by now. Get to work. Excellent work, everyone. It looks like all of your Sim Men are conscious now. But remember, they still have injuries that need to be treated. Well, it looks like everybody gets it. Let's move on to the test. Now that we've covered the basic symptoms and treatments in CLS, it's time for your test. Your Sim Man will be displaying certain symptoms. It will be your job to treat him. I will monitor your progress from my workstation. This is not a cooperative test. No cheating will be allowed. No reckless eyeballing, no rubbernecking, and no talking. When you've completed all your treatments, I'll check your final grade on my computer. Your Sim Man now has his first injury. Begin. You better figure it out. Remember, soldier, if you don't get this right, he's dead. Remember what we've gone over. This isn't anything new for any of you guys. You already finished, soldier? Let's see how you scored. Welcome to the Connex Mount Site and Shoot House Training Course. Today, we will take the shoot, move, and communicate principles that you've learned and put them all together. Complete the objectives, spot and engage the enemy targets, and follow the instructions of the cadre. This training is for time, so make sure you watch the timers. If you miss a target, 10 seconds will be added to your final score. If you hit a friendly, we'll add 15 seconds. All right, hero, get in position. Go, go, go! Mantle over the objects and onto the connex. Drop down to the area below and secure the objective. You have entered a take and hold objective. Stay in the area to secure this objective. Engage the enemies as they're spotted on your BFT.
Enemy contact!
Enemy spotted! Enemy spotted! Enemy spotted!
Objective secured. Continue to engage the targets as they appear.
Enemy spotted! Enemy spotted! Enemy spotted!
Enemies neutralized. Move out through the door behind you. Pick up the M83. An enemy sniper has pinned you down. Throw a smoke grenade to conceal your movement across the open area. Wait for the smoke to build, then sprint across. All right, you're concealed now. Move out. Enemy spotted east. Engage the enemies through the window as they appear. Phase one complete. Move out to the shoot house to begin the next phase.
Are you ready? Let's go, go, go!
You must enter the room for the targets to appear. Don't stand in the doorway. Throwing a flashbang into the room will give you a few seconds off the timer and prove your score.
Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for attending today's graduation. Standing proudly on the parade field before you are the Army's newest Guardians of Freedom. Graduates, the challenges you faced during training were difficult by design. Your drill sergeants pushed you further than you thought your limits would allow, but you never quit, and you became Army strong. You learned that real strength derives from cohesive teams made up of well-trained soldiers who trust and care for each other. The training you received laid the foundation necessary for you to become an elite warrior. Even though you will be equipped with the world's most advanced technologies, remember, the Army values are your moral compass. Ladies and gentlemen, the Army is proud to present our latest generation of warriors, the soldiers of America's Army.